Hello all, this is Dswank. I am in Minecraft in the Pixelmon world, and I've actually got a few things I want to show off, and one thing that I probably should do. Let me bring this back up. Really? Okay. Flamethrower? There we go. Smog. You know smog. What does smog do? Ooh. 30 is... I don't think I want you to know smog. But yeah. Okay. Well, first off, between the cloning video and now, I caught a Zoria and a, what is the baby Lucario called? I can't remember, but I caught both of them and they have leveled up. Also, I had a very happy Eevee, and it leveled up into an Umbreon. And just to make sure I understood how the mechanics worked, for a second time, I leveled up my, I turned my, another Eevee into, a Flareon. Yes, words. I'm already stumbling over them. But yeah, easiest way to get Eevee happy is you put down one of these, which is a ranch, and you just fill it, up with the Eevees. Now... I also have some eggs that I am going to be dealing with. And I want to pick you back up because you're not staying here. Oh, thunderstorm. Not what I want. Not what I want. Not when I have this lodge that I built here in the jungle made out of wood. And it's a big lodge. Oh. Can I sleep the storm away? Or are you going to be stupid? Yeah, I slept the storm away. It's day. It's still raining. But this is the Mew Club. Or Mew something or other. I don't remember what I called it. But you have to have caught a Mew. And you see, there's count of two. Well, I started... I've been kind of... figuring out how the system works. And legendaries spawn based on where active characters are on the server. So if there's no active characters near the jungle, odds are a Mew will not spawn. However, since I'm here, a Mew, the odds increase that there's going to be a Mew. While I was building this, two Mews spawned in the jungle. I only found one of them. The other one I was looking in a different jungle hills and never found it. If my theory is correct, the Mew, actually, it will either spawn like back down there in this area, or it will spawn... just inside my gate, right in here. So, if my figuring is right, Mews will be spawning just kind of in this area. Now, they don't spawn nearly as fast as others, but while I've been here for 6 hours while messing around building that club, and... there have been a significant decrease in the number of Pokemon spawned, and a Garudon never spawned at all. And Garudons were spawning like mad over at the other area. Like, every time something would spawn, it would be a Garudon. So, and they haven't spawned once I've been over here. So, I think I've figured that out. So, that's kind of why I built this, was I was doing something while, waiting for Mews to spawn. Now, in my PC, you will see, here's my second Mew. I've also caught a Klang and another Tropius, a bigger Onix, a Rhydon, and some other things just because. But, let's see. Things that I wanted to show off. Well, one, I wanted to move the egg so I could catch them. And, oh, Rylou. I have two Rylous. Or have had two Rylous. I wanted my Nidos. Here. They're level 30. And I wanted to level my Nidos up. Which, I'm not sure if I brought the... Yes, I have the item with me. Okay. So. Well, one, I have the eggs, and if you... Summer, look at them. Sounds can be heard coming from inside. It will hatch soon. So, and it's based off of how far you walk as to when the eggs will hatch. So, yeah. While that's going, I am going to come over here. Hey, Nido. Oh, help if I... Huh. Nidorino is evolving. I bet it's going to be a Nidoking. And you get the sparkle effect. This is what all the evolutions look like. And Nidoking. Okay. That's... Yay. Alright, Nidoking. Not a particularly big one. Does look kind of fierce, but if I go here and summary. Status, okay. Growth, enormous. Now, if I look back here, growth, ordinary. So this thing should be huge when it turns into a Nido Queen, which I'm kind of hoping it is. I mean, it's already a big'un, so let's see where this goes. And it's growing. And let's see what she looks like. Okay. Not as big as I thought, but let's compare the two. Good lord, she's gonna crush you, dude. Sheer mechanics. They're mind-boggling. But yeah, that is a big Nido Queen. But yeah, so I have my Nidos leveling. Now, something else you'll notice. I have these. These are XP shares. And I'm trying to remember how they were made. XP share, XP all, XP all is one you have to find. XP share. You have glowstone across the top, aluminum, and lapis. And they hold on to them, and as long as they're holding them, they share XP. And look, my eggs hatched into Eevees. So I have a bunch of level 1 Eevees. Which I'm actually not that interested in right now. I'm going to hold on to them so I can level them into the other Eevees. But, oh, cool. I can get Fennekins. Yay, Fennekin. Alright, I want you. And I want you. And I want Kit. Where is Kit? Kit, Kit, Kit. There's Kit. But yeah, I have my functioning team here. And odds are I'm going to level the Umbreon and Flareon up, and then, well, odds are I'm going to level all the Pokemon that I have up as high as I can get them, these six, and then try and do the same with opposite genders. The Flareon and Umbreon, since they're opposite, that's easy. Zoark and Zoara is going to be harder, because I'm going to need either catch another one or hope that I can get the Ditto to work. But breed those Pokemans, and yeah, breed them, get a level them up to 100, breed them, and hopefully get some Pokemans that have some really good stats, and just cycle through, breed them, get them to high level, breed them again, trying to stack stats. And that's going to be, I mean, I've got my team here that I'm going to be running with. I'll occasionally trade one out so I can fly. Probably would be Lucario that'll get traded out. And, like, if I'm doing a lot of stuff with water, I'll probably evolve one of my Eevees into the Vaporeon. Just so I have water. But on a different subject, we have, okay, so we have the house, or the club, or Club Mew, that was it. And it says, please no entrance without Mew, and I have blank rooms. I'd like to put somebody here, like a guy who can sell, like, Pokeballs or something, because I think that would be appropriate. And then we have rooms. And this one's my room. I love the ceilings. And I like the chandeliers and the lights. And I have my Mew count. So. And we have healer and PC here. And I want to put some benches around this. But I don't have the materials here for it. I'd like to put a bench right there to fill that line up. But yeah, I started building this after the first Mew spawn that I could never found. And then while building it, and I was working on walling in the second floor, when the Mew spawned down here that I caught. So, yeah. Some people were afraid that I'd just clear-cut the forest, or the jungle. But I liked this. This turned out to fit relatively well, and just feel good. So, I'm going to, I really do like this structure. I may claim I've already built my house. Oh god. Okay, I didn't die. Yay. I do want to build another house, that's near my town. But I like this. Now, to kind of cheatsy teleport. My gym. I've been building a gym for my Pokemon since, that was one of our goals. And sorry about that, I punched the microphone and everything went insane. Now, the gym, Dust City Gym, you can kind of see on the mini-map where it is compared to the town that I've subsumed. It's all made out of seared block, which I cooked and seared myself with the whole... Same with moving all the lava and everything else in here. I did all... Everything I have built, I built legit. Specifically so that if Fuzzy or Draco try and cheap their way through it by using console commands, I can harass them. But everywhere that there is a glowstone, there would be a trainer. So you can come in, and it kind of is your platforming skills. You have to walk either this way or that way. Battle. And then there'd be a battle here. And then through here, and Draco said something about a mod or something he may add that will allow me to have a separate obsidian of a nether gate for my gem. But my plan is when the nether gates, when I have that, I will have a, I'd love it if I could build like a glass walkway out over one of these lava pits, and then have it enclosed in glass, and then have lava pouring on the sides, and have this on either side of the walkway out there, have Garudons in the ranch block functioning like guards on either side of the door. But yeah, that's kind of the plan I was looking at. And I was going to build... Well, I was going to have the Pokemon that... I was going to level every Pokemon that would be in that gym. See how well that worked. So, yeah. There's that, and I guess the last thing I need to do, since this is going to teleport me back and teleport me to Draco's house, his portal was the first one finished. I need to head from here back to my park. Which, if I zoom in here, here's the gym. Here's the town. Here's what will be my replacement for the Poke Center and the Pokestop right there. And it's going to be a tower. And I'm going to have multiple instances of salespeople in the tower. And then on the top of the tower is going to be my house in this area. So... let's see, I want to go to Dust Park. So, yeah, I've got Charmander, Eevee, a Vulpix, my first Mew, Charmander, my big Onix. And, yeah, everybody's seen Dust Park before, but what they haven't all seen is my pretty much completed underground base. I have my crafting area. I have my own nether portal, which doesn't return me here, sadly. I have my smeltery, which you've seen before, the cloning machine and the fossil machine. This goes down into the mine. I missed that block. That block is going to be a pain to fix, but I will. And then up here is kind of my temporary base that I've been working on. I have my nether wart and all this up here. I have plenty of lava for this. I've also harvested some cobalt and ardite. And that mix to make melanium, which is supposed to be really, really good. But yeah, that's really golding.
Golding.
I got salmon. But yes, that's kind of what I have been working on. So with that update, what I'm going to be doing is going back, goofing around a little bit more in the jungle area. And, I don't know if I ever showed off the bridge that I built. There's the bridge that I built. While I'm here, I need to grab some oak as well. But, I'm pretty sure I have some oak in my box of toys. But anyway, this storage box. These were expensive to make. And they hold items based on their total count. Which kind of sucks. Let's see. Oh, I don't have any oaks.
Okay.
Now, something I do want to add, because it has come up in discussions with everybody else on the server. I do have, because of what I do right now, in addition to YouTube, I have, working for family and doing odd jobs and things like that, while looking for a real job. I'm gonna be on more, therefore legendaries spawn more while I'm on, therefore odds are I'm going to end up catching legendaries, more legendaries than anybody else, just because I'll be on more. Also the fact that I am trying to math out how this works. Excuse me, good lord. And by doing that, I'm going to, well, some would argue take the fun out of it, but that's because that's kind of my training for real life, is to look at trends and things like that. So I do, and then try and figure out how to profit from it, and that's just who I am now. So, one of the things that was brought up was the idea of once you have in our discussion on this, was once you have a Mewtwo, that you don't catch any more Mew. And that's one of those, I'm fine for that when nobody else is on, when other people are on the server, that they get their chance to go after the Mew. But, I mean, it's not like there's just one. There's in theory, infinite amount of the legendaries, just like all the other Pokemans. And if I'm the only one on and one spawns, I'm gonna try and catch it. Even if the end result is I don't get anything out of it, because I'm not going to try and get multiple Mewtwos or something like that. But if I get a multiple Mews, and other people are having issues like Fuzzy had in his first season, where no matter how hard he tried, he always got, a Ditto instead of a Mewtwo. I have no problem letting, if other people want to use the Mews that I catch to try and get their Mewtwos. I think I'd wait until they, on principle, until they catch at least one. But, yeah, I mean, that's kind of how I see it. I don't know if I've made my case well or not, or what other people think of that. Whether the people would argue I'm just being greedy or what, but I kind of want to level this out a little bit, but I think that's going to happen. Yeah, I'm fine with that. There we go. But yes, I mean, if I'm on and the only one on and a Mew spawns and I catch it, that's not going to stop it from spawning for anybody else. And the fact that I caught it, I was the only one on it, I didn't remove any resource from anybody else. And the fact that if other people need it, if this is something that for the goal people are working on, they need a Mew. If nothing else, I can use it as leverage to trade for something else. Which some might see it as, it's kind of looking at it like a Pokemon is, I don't know if you'd call that, no, it wouldn't be future training, trading Pokemon, but I am investing in the potential value of a Mew. I think I'd still, if I was here, and I already had a Mewtwo, and a Mew spawned, I think I would still try and catch it. If there was nobody else on server. If there was somebody else on server, I'd go, hey, Mew spawned, teleport to me. If you want it. And I think that's how I would handle the situation.
Alright, I was just playing around well after, and you probably can't see much, but if you look in the upper left corner, you will see I'm fighting a Mew. This is a wild Mew. I am attempting to catch said wild Mew. This will be my fourth wild Mew that I have caught. And my first one that I've managed to get on camera. So, I did not expect to stumble across one when I did, and so I was able to quickly start recording, but I didn't have things set up to catch my voice, so I'm post-narrating this. I was very afraid at this point that I was going to lose it. Because I've set it basically on fire. It's in a fire vortex. Also, my Delphox is getting a little strong for this. So, but there we go. I now have 4. And you'll see, that's where my base is. That's how close I am to my base. I have done a lot, and you can also see I have done a lot of upgrading to the surrounding area since the last time you saw anything. All of this has been me just chilling, waiting for a Mew to spawn so that I can, catch it and get it on footage. So, I did. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, go ahead, hit like, subscribe, leave a comment below, tell me what you thought, and I will see you next time. Until then, buh-bye.